Good morning, students. I hope you all are doing well at your places and taking the utmost care of yourself. So, let's start today's lecture. In today's video lecture, we will discuss about the framing of Constitution of India and its features. So, before starting the lecture, we will just discuss about the definition of Constitution. Like, what is the meaning of Constitution? What do you mean by Constitution? So, before getting into the deep the definition of Constitution, we will take an example. Like we are playing a game. So let's take an example of cricket. So in cricket game, there are certain rules and regulations that how the game will won by the player, one team or the other team. Okay, how the players are, what can I say, declared out, and how to ball. If the ball is above the waist height, full top, like the ball is above the waist height, it will declare as a no ball. Okay, if the player played short in an air and someone caught it, someone catch it, then the batsman can be called out. Okay, so these are the some kinds of rules and regulations in cricket. Okay, so if we are applying or we are having the rules and regulations in cricket in the same manner while we are discussing about the governing entire country. So for the same, we also require rules and regulations for governing whole administration of country. So here, the one definition can be very simple definition, like a set of systematic rules which governs a country, it's called Constitution. Okay, Constitution means a rule book where all the rules and regulations are written in a legal form in a one book. It is called Constitution, and all the citizens of the country are bounded to follow it. Is it clear? So this is the definition. Now, why do we require a Constitution? So first of all, we know very well, as I told you earlier, if we are, like suppose if there are no rules in a cricket, then how you will enjoy it? And sometimes we feel pressure if our favorite team are playing a game where is a chances of 50-50 or 70-30 or 30-70 for winning or for losing. So that time of pressure is created. If there are no rules, which team will win this match? So there will not be any kind of curiosity will there, and there is no craze. There will not be any kind of craze in game. So that's why rules and regulations are there. So in a country, we have to maintain rules and regulations because we are having the different peoples living in our country. So each and everywhere for maintaining the discipline, we require constitution. Okay. So now, how do our constitution was framed? So as we know very well, when Britain Parliament passed the Indian Independence Act in 1946, they declared in that act that India will be free by the British rule by 1947. Okay, so for the sake, the Mountbatten came to India as a form of last viceroy, and he advised the political leaders of country that if you are going to have independent country, so before that you should have constitution. Okay, because without constitution you cannot rule on your country, because it requires certain kinds of rules and regulations to govern a country in a proper way, in a managed way. So that's why you require a constitution, and that's why that time the Constituent Assembly was formed. There were total 389 members. How much? 389 members were there in Constituent Assembly, and many of the prominent leaders and scholars were included in this Constituent Assembly, like Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Okay, then Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, then Kanhaiyalal Munshi, Krishna Swami Allari Iyer, okay, Krishnamachari, T.T. Krishnamachari, then Dr. Bhimrao Babasaheb Ambedkar, Vijayalakshmi Pandit, Sarojini Naidu. So these much prominent leaders and scholars were there in this Constituent Assembly, and from every corner, each and every corner of the country, the persons were called. Why? Because we are now making the constitution for entire country. Okay, so we have to look out each and every religion, each and every caste, each and every geographical condition, and each and every language. So that's why we require each and every, what can I say, representative from different criteria. Okay, so that's why there were 389 members from the entire country. Okay, they started their work on 9th December 1946. That was the first meeting of Constituent Assembly. Okay, then after 11th December, there was a second meeting, 1946, and 13th December 1946, there was a third meeting. In these three meetings, they have started their work in the Constituent Assembly. In second meeting, they have choose a temporary president for Constituent Assembly. If I am not mistaken, Chatish Verma was appointed as a president of Constituent Assembly, but he was a temporary. In 13th December 1946, in third meeting, Dr. Rajendra Prasad was appointed as a president of Constituent Assembly, and Dr. Bhimrao Babasaheb Ambedkar was appointed as a chairman of drafting committee. Okay, so in these three meetings, these decisions were taken by one temporary and two permanent appointment has been scheduled in this meeting. Dr. Rajendra Prasad as a president of Constituent Assembly and Dr. Bhimrao Babasaheb Ambedkar was appointed as a chairman of drafting committee. Please student, take care here, because many of the students are confusing between Rajendra Prasad and Dr. Bhimrao Babasaheb Ambedkar. So, see, there is a trick, you can remember this thing by pra and pra. Pra say president and pra say prasad. So there will not be any kind of confusion between this. Okay? Now, Constituent Assembly met for 166 sessions. How much? 166 sessions they made, and they took 2 years, 11 months, and 18 days to complete this constitution. Well, almost they have taken 3 years to complete the constitution work. Okay? So, this much time they have taken to complete our constitution. Okay? When constitution was prepared, there were total 395 articles were there and 8 appendices were there. Okay? So, this was the size of the constitution. Now, see, when the constitution was, when constitution was prepared, the constitution was prepared on 26th November 1949. On 26th November 1949, the constitution was prepared, but it was not applied. Why? That I will tell you later. When it was applied, after 2 months, on 26th January 1950, applied. And that's it. We are celebrating 26th January as Republic Day of India. Because after implementing the Constitution of India, India declared as a Republic country. Okay? So now, why they have waited for 2 months? So, I will drag you in some previous incidents. If you remember, in 1930, the member of the Congress have taken the oath of Purna Swaraj, of complete independence in 1930. 26th January 1930, in the leadership of Jawaharlal Nehru, what was the place? Lahore, the bank of River Ravi. They took the oath of complete independence. That's why, to make a memorable, that day memorable, we applied our constitution on 26th January 1950. Okay? So, this is the preparation of constitution. Is it clear? Now, we will discuss about the most important topic, that is preamble. What? Preamble. See, preamble. Preamble, we can say that preamble is a highlight of constitution or index of constitution. preamble, sorry, constitution starts with the preamble. So we can say the preamble is the first page of the constitution. Okay, so in preamble, that is clearly mentioned, like what are the features of the constitution. It is explained in a short in the preamble. So that is a, what can I say, the preamble is the reflecting the ideas of constitution, like the drafting members' psyche, their psychology are clearly presented in a preamble, because in preamble all the things are mentioned clearly and in very short form. Like, see, in preamble I am just reciting, because all the thing, all the page of preamble is given in the textbook. We the people of India, on this is the 26th November of 1949, we are declaring that the country, we are democratic, socialistic, then secular and republican sovereign country, who will provide each and every citizen that justice in every form, like economic, social and political. We will provide the liberty of thoughts and our idea expression, and we will also provide the liberty of to choose their religion. Okay, and also we will try to establish a fraternity among all the nation, and we will emerge as a developed or superior country in the world. That is not mentioned here, I am just adding my words. So this is the preamble, and at the last it is written here, on this day, like 26th of November 1949, we enact and adopt ourselves, give ourselves this constitution. Okay, so this is the preamble, and many of the thinkers, and Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, were considered preamble as a soul of the constitution, soul of constitution. That is very big. What comparison? That preamble is the soul of constitution. Okay. Now preamble is having the three kind of pillar. That will, the pillars of the preamble that we will discuss in next lecture. So this is all about today's lecture. In this video lecture, we have discussed about the definition of constitution and the constituent assembly in detail. Okay. See. We have discussed about those details which are not in the textbook as well. Okay, so this is very well explained. Still, if you have any kind of doubt, you can ask me in the live session. Okay, so till then, have a good day. Take care and bye everyone.